Hello, everyone. It's December of 2022. Whew, we made it. We made it to the end of this year. And I am so happy to be here with you. Here's my three productivity tips for closing the year strong. Let's hop in. Well, I don't know about you, but I am happy to be seeing the end of 2022. It's been an exciting year, but also full of many challenges. So now let's take a moment to just take a step back. I heard one of our leaders say that it's important to make sure that you're at the intersection of doing good and doing well. And I don't know how to do that without taking a moment to exhale and really take a look at what's happened in this last year, and especially in this last 6 months. So I have a few ideas how you can use Microsoft 365 with yourself or your team to do that. Let's take a look. First off, you know I love Microsoft Loop. You can use Microsoft Loop in chat with self, and I have another video on that. But why don't you start a gratitude list in Microsoft Loop? Write down the things that you can really appreciate about at least the last 6 months and the people that you appreciate. This is also something I started with my team so that we could share our insights and the gratitude that we have, not only for the work that we've accomplished, but for each other. You can put this loop in a chat with self, and maybe you keep it up on a monthly basis. That might be a great resolution for 2023. But right now, just make sure that you yourself are taking time to take a step back. Putting people first means really dealing with ourselves on a holistic level. We're not just accomplishments and challenges and experiments and services. We are human beings, and we need to engage our full self when we're thinking about our work and about what we want to do as we develop our career. So take a moment to make that gratitude list. Use Microsoft Loop where you can collaborate with others or keep it just for yourself in your chat with self in Microsoft Teams. The second thing is we want to keep learning, right? We want to feed that curiosity. And this isn't just about technology. This is about anything that interests you. If you're like me, you're interested in more things than you can possibly get done in any given period. So I like to keep a list. You can use a planner to do this, and you can categorize those buckets by different types of learning, learning about technology, improving your people management skills, improving your project management skills, or learning something new like a communication style or what have you. You can assign those things to yourself. You can use Planner to do that, or more advanced tools like Microsoft 365 Learning Pathways or Viva Learning. But make yourself a plan to feed your own intellectual and curiosity. Again, this goes to feeding yourself, staying engaged, and making sure that your learning is also accruing something that's meaningful to you. I'm also going to add a few things about cooking. There's some new recipes I want to try out, some new things I want to learn, and I want to make sure to make time for that along with all the other work that I do. That also feeds me. It feeds my creativity. So what feeds your creativity? Figure it out, maybe learn something new, and make sure to know that you don't have to learn all by yourself. One of the most successful things that I've done recently with my team is schedule a study hall hour each week. This study hall, we don't do a lot of talking. There's no presentations. We happen to use it as time to update our portfolio management tools, but you can use it for any topic. It puts it on people's calendars, but also it brings people together. We have someone, usually myself, who is the monitor of the study hall, and then people can ask me questions during the study hall if they run into something that they don't understand. This is also a fantastic way to learn a new skill or topic. Pick something together as a team that you all want to learn that will benefit your organization or your group as a whole, and study together. This is something we all did in school, but then we leave and somehow we feel like we have to do everything on our own. It builds morale and connectivity throughout the team when you're doing these study halls or learning activities together. So make sure to try that out with your team. Lastly, remember that gratitude list? Hopefully there were some names of people on it. Share the praise. Share praise with people here at the end of the year, or wait until January when you know they're going to be back. Of course, you can use Viva Insights to share praise, and it'll go directly into chat or a channel. Oftentimes, I like to just write a simple email and make sure to copy that person's manager or other relevant people so that they know how much I appreciate their partnership in driving things forward. Relationships are what make my business work, as well as the technology. And that's probably true for you. Make sure you're taking a moment to think about the people who have contributed to your success and how can you contribute to theirs. Of course, it's always a good idea to use the official tools that you have in your organization for sharing positive feedback. But this is a more informal thing. And that's why I recommend, you know, use email or use the tools built into Microsoft 365. Either way is great, but make sure that you are sharing that praise. There's nothing more important than finding gratitude, staying curious, and investing in the relationships that make us all a success. I certainly have found that while I've been out in the community this year, it's been so wonderful to come back to live events and see everyone in person. And I'm looking forward to doing more of that in 2023. But right now, I'm going to rest and reflect on how meaningful this year has been for me and how important it is that I have this relationship with all of you. Thank you for all of your support through all of our channels, whether it's on our Microsoft Adoption Twitter handle, out in the community, or on the new Community Days site. We appreciate you, and we know that everything that we do is done because we're doing it together. Thank you so much. Happy holidays. Enjoy your time off, whatever you celebrate, and I'll see you in 2023.